गुड इवनिंग टू वन एंड ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू अवर फेवरेट वीडियो चैनल SGVS. दिस इज बी रमेश कुमार, जेएल इन मैथमेटिक्स. नाउ इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड कंसिस्टेंस एंड इनकंसिस्टेंट सिस्टम्स इन सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस. नाउ इन द सेम कॉन्सेप्ट वी सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स टू दीज सिस्टम्स. फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस द प्रॉब्लम्स इन होमोजीनियस लीनियर सिस्टम्स. Now the first problem is, here the problem is solve the system of equations x plus y minus 3z plus 2w equals to 0, 2x minus y plus 2z minus 3w equal to 0, 3x minus 2y plus z minus 4w equal to 0, minus 4x plus y minus 3z plus w equal to 0. So here we observe that in this system, the right side values are always equal to 0. Therefore, this system is homogeneous linear system. That is the first observation. In second one, in this system, there are 4 equations and 4 variables. There are 4 equations and 4 variables. Now, the system may have unique solution or infinitely many solutions. Now here, first we take the coefficient of the matrix of the given system and find rank of the coefficient matrix and observe the rank and the number of variables are equal. Therefore, the system has trivial solution, that is zero solution. Or otherwise, the rank is less than number of variables. Now the system has non-trivial solution, that is infinitely many solutions. Now first we compute the rank of the coefficient matrix. Now we take the coefficient matrix of the given system. Now the coefficient matrix is 1, 1, minus 3, 2, 2, minus 1, 2, minus 3, 3, minus 2, 1, minus 4, minus 4, 1, minus 3, 1. So this is the coefficient matrix. Let it be taken some A. Now here, this matrix will be reduced to echelon form. Now using row transformations only. First of all, we observe the first row of the first element is, first element of the first row is 1. Here, using this one, the remaining first elements of second row, third row and fourth row are zeros. Here, multiply with 2, subtract from second one, that is 0. Multiply with 3 and subtract from third one, this is 0. Multiply with 4 and adding fourth row and first row, it will be also 0. Now, these are the transformations. Now the transformations are R2 changes here R2 minus 2R1. Similarly, R3 changes R3 minus 3R1. Similarly, R4 changes R4 plus 4R1. Here in this one, minus contains the first element. So the sign minus already containing the element 4. Now adding 4th row and 1st row, that is that will be 0. Now using the 2nd row transformation, now here the 1st row does not change, 1 1 minus 3 2, in 2nd row 2 minus 2 0, minus 1 minus 2 minus 3, similarly 2 2 3 yeah, 6, minus 3 minus plus, 2 plus 6 8, minus 3, minus 4, minus 7. This is second row. Similarly, third row, 3 minus 3, 0, minus 2, minus 3 into 1, minus 5, 1, minus 3 into, minus 3, plus 3, 1 minus 3 into minus 3, plus 9, 1 plus 9, 10. Similarly, minus 4, minus 3 into 2, minus 6, minus 4, minus 6, minus 10. Now using fourth order transformation, minus 4 plus 4, 0. Similarly, 1 plus 4, 5. Minus 3, minus 12. So here we observe that minus 3 plus 4 into minus 3. Minus 3, minus 12. Minus 15. Similarly, 1 plus 4 into 2. 8. 1 plus 8, that is 9. So this is the reduction matrix of the given matrix. Here we observe that in third row, minus 5, 10, minus 10. These are multiples of 5. Now divide with minus 5 to third row. Using the row transformation, R3 changes R3 by minus 5. Now here the resultant matrix is, here the first 3 rows does not change. 1, 1. Minus 3, 2, 0, minus 3, 8, minus 7, 0, minus, here divide with minus 5, that is 0, minus 5 by minus 5, 1, 10 by minus 5, minus 2, minus 10 by minus 5, plus 2. Fourth row does not change, 0, 5, minus 15, 9. Now here, using this one, now here divide with minus 5 to third row. Now 0 by minus 5, 0. Minus 5 by minus 5, 1. 10 by minus 5, minus 2. Minus 10 by minus 5, plus 2. So this is the reduced third row. First row, third, second row and fourth row does not change. Now here we observe that using this one, the second element of fourth row converted to 0. Now here multiply with 5 to third row and subtract from fourth row. Now, R4 changes, R4 minus 5R3. Here the first two rows does not change. Zero, 1, minus 2, 2. Zero, 5 minus 5, 0. Minus 15, minus, plus 10, minus 5. Here, 9, minus 10. Minus 1. Now using minus 3, it will be also 0. Multiply with 3 and adding second and third row transformations. Now the second element of third row will be also 0. Now using the transformation R3, changes 3R3 plus R2. Here the first row does not change. Second row also does not change. Third row, 0, 3 into 1 plus 3, 3, plus, 3 minus 3. This is also 0, 3 into minus 2, minus 6 plus 8. Minus 6 plus 8. 2, 3 2 jar, 6 minus 7. 6 minus 7, minus 1. So 0, 0, minus 5, minus 1. Now this is the resultant matrix. Here multiply with 5 to third row, multiply with 2 to fourth row and adding third row and fourth row, minus 5 also converted to 0. Now the transformation is R4 changes to R4 plus 5R3. Here first two rows does not change. Third row also does not change. In fourth row, 0, 0. This is also 0. 2 into R4. 2 into minus 1. Minus 2, minus 5. So, minus 2, minus 5, minus 7. So, now here, we observe that we cannot apply any row transformation. The remaining elements does not change to zeros. Now, this is the echelon form of the given quotient matrix. So, which is echelon form? Of A, the given matrix A. And here the number of non-zero rows. Equals to the number of non-zero rows. Here we observe the first row is non-zero row, second row, first element is zero, remaining elements are non-zeros. So this is also non-zero row. In third row, two elements are zeros, other two elements are non-zeros. Therefore, this is also non-zero row. In fourth row, three elements are zeros, final fourth element is non-zero. Now here, in non-zero row, at least one element is non-zero. The type of row is called non-zero rows. Now here, the four rows are non-zero rows. Therefore, the number of non-zero rows equals to 4. Therefore, rank of coefficient matrix A equals to R equals to 4. And also we observe, in the given system, the number of variables or the number of unknowns also 4. Number of unknowns or variables equals to n equals to 4. Now here we observe, rank is 4, number of unknowns also 4. Therefore, R equals to n equals to 4. Now, here we observe, rank equals to number of variables. Therefore, it has unique solution. It has unique solution. That unique solution is trivial solution. That unique solution is trivial solution. Therefore, here the solution of the given system is x equals to y equals to z equals to w equals to 0. This is the solution for the given system of equations, which is homogeneous linear system. In this homogeneous linear system, which is the trivial solution, here number of non-zero rows equals to rank. Therefore, here the solution is trivial solution only. There exists only trivial solution. Now the second problem is, solve the system of equations x plus 3y plus 2z equals to 0, 2x minus y plus 3z equals 0, 3x minus 5y plus 4z equals 0, and fourth equation is x plus 17y plus 4z equals 0. This is homogeneous system because of the right side values equals to zeros. So first of all, we observe that in this system there are three variables, that is x, y, z, and four equations. Now clearly this system has non-trivial solution and also it has infinitely many solutions. Now we go to the solution. First we write the system in matrix form. Now the matrix form is, here we take the coefficients 1, 3, 2, 2 minus 1, 3, 3 minus 5, 4, 1, 17, 4. This is coefficient matrix. Now the variable matrix is x, y, z. We take column wise, and constant matrix 0, 0, 0. Now which equals to A, which equals to X, which equals to O, which implies the matrix form is AX equals to O. Now here we take the coefficient matrix, let it be A, is 1, 3, 2, 2, 1, minus 1, 3, 3, minus 5, 4, and 1, 17, 4. Now, here we can apply row transformations and it will convert to echelon form. Now, here we observe that the first element of first row is 1. Now, multiply with 2, subtract from second row, this is 0. Multiply with 3, subtract from third row, this is also 0. And subtract from fourth row to first row, this is also 0. Now, here the first elements of second, third, fourth rows are zeros. Now, the transformations are R2 changes, R2 minus 2R1, R3 changes, R3 minus 3R1, R4 changes, R4 minus R1. Now here, using first transformation, the resultant matrix is, first row does not change, 1, 3, 2, in second row, so 2 minus 2, 0, minus 1, minus 2 into 3, minus 6, minus 1 minus 6, minus 7, here 3 minus 2 into 2, 3 minus 4, that is minus 1. Similarly, 3 minus 3 into 1, 0, minus 5, minus 9, minus 14, 4 minus 3 into 2, minus 6, 4 minus 6, that is minus 2. Here using fourth transformation R4, 1 minus 1, 0, and 17 minus 3, 14, and 4 minus 2, plus 2, 4 minus 2, plus 2. Now this is the resultant matrix. The second elements of second, third row and fourth row are minus 14 and plus 14. First of all, it will convert it to zeros. Multiply with 2 to second row and subtract from third row. This can be 0. And multiply with 2, adding with fourth row, this is also 0. Now here, the transformations are R3 changes, R3 minus 2 into R2, R4 changes, R4 plus 2 into R2. Now here, the matrix is, the first row does not change, second row also does not change, third row 0, 0, 0, this is also 0, 0, 0. So here we observe that this is the echelon form of the coefficient matrix, which is in echelon form. Now in this echelon form, the number of non-zero rows equals to 2. The number of non-zero rows equals to 2. Here the rank is the number of non-zero rows. Therefore, rank equals to R equals to 2. And also, the number of variables, R3. The number of unknowns are variables, N equals to 3. Here we observe that R is less than N, which implies 2 is less than 3. So here, this relation says the given system has non-trivial solution. Therefore, the given system has non-trivial solution. Here, the number of linear independent solutions equals to n minus r, that equals to 3 minus 2 equals to 1. Now we take two equations using echelon form. Here 1 is coefficient of x, 3 is coefficient of y, 2 is coefficient of z. Now we take the equation. Therefore, the equations are x plus 3y plus 2z equals to 0. Similarly, minus 7 is coefficient of y, minus 1 is coefficient of z. Now the second equation is minus 7y minus z equals to 0. Now which is equation 1, which is equation 2. Now here, we observe that in this two equations and three variables. Now here, put z equals to some scalar. We take z equals to some scalar, c, r, k, r, t, any scalar. Put z equals to some k,
then seven y equals to seven y equals to minus j, that equals to minus k, which implies y equals to minus k by 7. Y equals to minus k by 7. Similarly, we find x value using equation 1. From equation 1, here x equals to minus 3y minus 2z. Now substitute the values of y and z. Minus 3 into minus k by 7 minus 2z. Z value is k, therefore minus 2k. Minus 2k. That equals to 3k by 7. Minus 3 into minus k plus 3k by 7 minus 2k. Here 7 2 job minus 14 plus 3. Minus 14 plus 3 minus 11 k. Minus 11 k by 7. So this is the value of x. Therefore the solution is x, y, z, matrix of x, y, z equals to x means minus 11 k by 7, y value minus k by 7, z value k. Now we take common k into minus 11 by 7 minus 1 by 7 and 1. So this is one linear independent solution for the given homogeneous system. This is the final solution for the given system. Now the third one is determine whether the following equations will have a non-trivial solution. If so, solve them. First of all, the given system has non-trivial or trivial solution. First of all, examine this solution. Now the third problem is determine whether the following equations will have a non-trivial solution. If so, solve them. So first of all, the given system may have trivial or non-trivial. First we check that using echelon form. Using transformations to find echelon form, and we observe rank and number of variables, and the system has trivial or non-trivial. First we check, then we find the solution of the given system. Now first we write the given system in matrix form. That is, first of all, here we observe that in the first equation, coefficient of x is 4. Generally, we take the coefficients, the first element of first row is 1. Now, here we observe, in this first equation, the coefficient of z is 1. Therefore, it will be rewritten by z plus 2y plus 4x plus 3w. Now, here we change the variables. Here we take, the first equation will be taken as z plus 2y plus 4x plus 3w equals to 0. Similarly, here also 4z plus 3y plus 6x plus 7w. Similarly, the third equation. Here the coefficient of z is 0. Now we take 0 into z plus y plus 2x plus w. So, this is the system. Now, here we observe in this system, there are 4 variables, 3 equations. There are 4 variables, 3 equations. Now, clearly we check this system has non-trivial solution. So, here we write the matrix form of the given system. The matrix form is 1, 2, 4, 3. 4, 3, 6, 7. 0, 1, 2, 1. This is the coefficient matrix. Now here, the variables are, the first variable is z, second variable is y, third variable is x, fourth variable is w. Here rewritten by the given equations by z y x w. The order is z y x w. Now the matrix form is, here we take this is A, this is X, this is G, O. Therefore A X equals to O. Now we take coefficient matrix A equals to 1, 2, 4, 3, 4, 3, 6, 7, 0, 1, 2, 1. Here we apply row transformations and it can be reduced to echelon form. So R2 changes, here multiply with 4 to first row and subtract from second row. R2 minus 4R1. Now here we observe the first element of third row already 0. Now we cannot apply any row transformation. Now use only one transformation, that is R2 minus 4R1. So that equals to, first row does not change, second row 4 minus 4, 0, 3 minus 4 into 2, minus 8, 3 minus 8, minus 5, 6 minus 4 into 4, 6 minus 16, that is minus 10, here 7 minus 4 into 3, 7 minus 12, that is minus 5, third row does not change. So this is the resultant matrix. Now here we observe, the second row is divided by minus 5. The second row is divided with minus 5. Now it can be reduced to 1. Now R2 changes. R2 divided by minus 5. Now the resultant matrix is, first row does not change, 1, 2, 4, 3. Second row 0, 1, 2, 1. 0, 1, 2, 1. Now here subtract from third row to second row, this will be 0. R3 changes, R3 minus R2. 1, 2, 4, 3, 0, 1, 2, 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 2, 0, 1 minus 1, 0. So which is very clear. Now here we observe that this is echelon form, which is in echelon form. Number of non-zero rows. Number of non-zero rows equals to, here the number of non-zero rows equals to 2. Therefore, rank of A equals to, here rank of A equals to number of non-zero rows, R equals to 2. And also we observe number of variables. Here the number of variables equals to 4. Therefore, the number of variables n equals to 4. Therefore, R is less than n, which implies 2 is less than 4. Now, the given system has non-trivial solution. Therefore, the given system has non-trivial solution. Here we observe that R equals to 2, n equals to 4. Therefore, the number of, we find the number of independent variables, independent solutions. Here we find the number of independent solutions, that is n minus r. So here n minus r independent solutions are there to the given system of linear equations. There are n minus r, that equals to 4 minus 2, that equals 2. So there are 2 independent solutions, independent solutions to the given system. Now here we take the equations in echelon form. That equations are, now here 1 is the coefficient of z, 2 is the coefficient of y, 4 is the coefficient of x, and 3 is the coefficient of W. Now the equation, first equation is
z plus 2y and 4x plus 4x and plus 3w. So this is the first equation using Euclidean form.
Similarly, the second equation is here 0 is the coefficient of z. Now this is 0. Now the next one is y. So y, the next one is x plus 2x, the next one is w plus w equals to 0. So here we observe there are two equations and four variables. Two equations and four variables. Now here we take two scalars. Here we take two scalars. Let us consider y equals to any scalar, or x equals to any scalar, or w equals to any scalar. Now here we take y and w. Y equal to some scalar c1 and w equals some scalar c2. Put y equals to some c1 and w equals to some c2. Therefore 2x equals to minus y minus w, that equals to minus y minus c1 minus c2. Therefore x equals to minus c1 by 2 minus c2 by 2. This is the x value. Similarly, we find z. Therefore, z equals to minus 2y minus 4x minus 3w. Now here we take right side 2y, 4x, 3w, that is z equals to minus 2y minus 4x minus 3w. Substitute the values of y, x, w in this equation, then we get the value of z. Now here minus 2, y means c1, so minus 2 c1 minus 4 x, x means minus c1 by 2 minus c2 by 2. Similarly minus 3 into w means c2, so that is 3 c2. So here minus 2 c1. Now here we take common 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 4 by 2 into c1 plus c2 minus 3 c2, so that equals minus 2 c1 plus 2 c1 plus 2 c2 minus 3 c2. Here it can simplify. Minus 2c1 plus 2c1 cancel, and z equals to 2c2 minus 3c2, that means minus c2. So this is the value of z. Now the solution is x, y, z, w, that equals to, here x means minus c1 by 2 minus c2 by 2, y means c1, z means minus c2, w plus c2. So this is the solution. Here it will be expand. Now here this solution can be expressed as two linear independent solutions, that is x, y, z, w equals to, here first we take common c1, the matrix form, the coefficient of c1 is minus 1 by 2, in the second element coefficient of c1 is 1, in third one, fourth one, c1 is not there, therefore we take zeros. So this is one of the solution, plus some scalar c2 into, here in the first element the coefficient of C2 is minus 1 by 2. In second element, C2 is not there. Now we take 0. Similarly, here C2, the coefficient of C2 is minus 1. Here also, in fourth element, the coefficient of C2 is plus 1. So, this is another solution. Now, this solution will be expressed as a linear combination of two independent solutions. That is C1 into minus 1 by 2, 1, 0, 0 plus C2 into minus 1 by 2, 0, minus 1, 1. Now, these are two linear independent solutions of the given system. Now, the linear independent solutions are, first one, minus x equals to minus 1 by 2, y equals to 1, z equals to 0, w also 0, and x equals to minus 1 by 2, y equals to 0, z equals to minus 1, and w also plus 1. This is the final two independent solutions of the given system. Now, this is the solution for the given problem. Now, same process followed for more problems, to practice more problems and understand this homogeneous system solutions. Now, thank you.